Hey guys, welcome to CR Entity Designer. It's Chetan here, and in this tutorial we are going to make another mechanical part. So now let's get started. To make this mechanical part, you need to open your blend file and shift A to add a mesh, add a cylinder, and we can go with the 12 words. Then select this, go to the edit mode, select this bottom words and delete them. Then set the origin to the geometry and snap it to the 3D cursor. After that, you need to press I for the insert operation. So just select this face and then press I for the insert operation. And then you need to adjust the scale over here. Select this edge and then scale it along the X and Y axis. Then you can select these faces and press X to delete these faces. My extra mode is turned on there. Then press I for the insert operation and delete that face loop which is there. Okay, then you need to select these edges and then extrude them along the X axis. Then you need to select this edge and then move it along the Y axis. Select everything, mesh, and then submit rights. Then if I press I for the insert operation, then there is a middle line, so that's why we are getting this. You can delete only the faces and press F to fill the gap. That's another way. But select this edge and then E to extrude it and scale it along the X and Y axis. Then press I for the insert operation. So after that, delete these faces and then E to select these edges and E to extrude it and move it along the X axis. Then E to extrude it and scale it down a little bit just to add more loop. Then select these words. So you need to select these words and press C, scale it. Scale them along the X axis and make them straight. Give the value 0 for the scale it along the X axis. Then select everything, mesh, and then submit rights. Then select this edge loop and use the loop tool and then make a circle proper. Then select these edges and move them along the X axis. And then select all these edges and then just scale them along the X axis and give the value 0. Just you need to press 0. Then you need to add the loop cuts like this. So select this press edges and then press F to fill the gap and select everything, mesh, and then submit rights. So you can see we have created a 2D planar shape with the right topology for the model. And now just we need to give it 3D form. So select these faces and press I and then press B also to remove that, and so we can remove the boundary there. So press B, you can see the boundary is turned off, so that's why you need to press B to turn on it. Otherwise you need to delete the faces in this way after this. So just select these faces and press X for to delete those faces. And then extrude this also. You can turn on your extrude mode. and then select this edge loop, and then E to extrude it and move it along the Z axis. Then select these edges, edge loops, and then you need to press E to extrude it and extrude it along the Z axis. So just select this edge loop, and if you want to try the different variations then you can, but I would like to go with the simple one. So just E to extrude it and move it along the Z axis. Then you need to select these all words and scale them along the Z axis and give the value 0. And so you will get these all words in the same level. Then you need to add the subdivision surface modifier. So just add that modifier, subd modifier, and increase level viewports up to 2. And now you need to add the necessary loop cuts. So before adding the loop cuts, you can go and take the symmetry of the bottom along the Z axis, and you can connect both top and bottom parts together. I forgot that, so before that I added the loop cuts before doing that, so I can do that in after adding the necessary loop cuts. So just see where you need to add more loop cuts and then add the loop cuts to maintain the form of the mesh. Then select everything mesh and then symmetrize and take the symmetry along the Z axis. And now just you need to select these edges and then bridge edge loop. Select these edges, make sure equal amount of words should be there on those edge loops, and then right click and then bridge edge loop. So just adjust the scale, and now just you need to fill these gaps which are there. So just we need to select these edges and then press F to fill the gap and add the necessary loop cuts. So you can see now the loop cuts are more. So that's why I was saying you that if it's possible, then take the symmetry before adding the necessary loop cuts, and then go ahead and add loop cuts. I forgot that, so that's why I'm doing right now. So you can see I'm adding the simple loop cuts, and with the select merge words you can do that. So select two words together, two or many words together, and press M to merge at the center. Then you can take the symmetry along the Z axis and that X axis, Y axis also. So in this way you can reduce your efforts. So just select these faces. And then you need to add one loop at there so you can use the insert operation for that. So just select these faces, shift select for that. And then press I for the insert operation and add one face loop at there. Then you can turn on your sub-D modifier and see where you need to add the more loop cuts. And there just add a loop cuts at there. So you can see we are getting the little bit of weirdness because the vertex were too close. And so that's why we need to keep the little bit of distance in these edge loops. So you can press the double tap G for the edge slide and just move these edge loops little bit away from each other. And then add the necessary loop cuts. So just select these faces and then press I for the insert operation. And you can see now the loop cuts are a little bit away from each other and we are not getting those weird result. And now you can see we created a decent model here. You can see the wireframe also. And now just we need to add the secondary details on this model. Before that, we need to apply that sub-D surface modifier in one level. You can do that. Otherwise, here are not too many curves mesh. So we can add more details without applying that modifier also. So you can see I'm selecting these faces. So you can see I have used a simple insert operation and then you extrude inside this little bit and create a little bit of design at there on your model. So here we need to add little bit of more loop cuts. So just add the loop cuts like this. Control R for that. And now we got a decent look. Just add a little bit of the boolean side there so it will give the good look for the model. So that's why I just add the loop cuts and add the center loop cuts like this. Then you need to turn on your X-ray mode and go to the face mode and then select these faces and then press I for the insert operation and right click and then use the loop tool and then circle and then scale it down them. And then press I for the insert operation one more time for just add more loops at there. So because we are using the subdivision surface modeling methods and then select these edges and then bridge edge loop. Same thing here, select these edges and then bridge edge loop. Then select these faces and then press I for the insert operation. and then turn on that subdivision surface modifier, and now you can see it's look decent. So decent kind of hard surface modeling we have done here. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Bye bye. See you in the next video. Take care.